So I'm very glad to introduce Yaakov Warshawski from the Hebrew University of Jerusalem and announce his talk on affine Springer fibers and alpacas.
Okay, so thank you very much. So maybe I will, in some sense, write the same title, but in different words, but somehow what is essentially I'm going to explain what somehow geometric interpretation. Of characters of delinguistic representations of periodic groups, where periodic, of course, will be mostly somehow. So it should work in the mixed characteristic as well, but at the moment I only checked the details, or we checked the details in the equal characteristic case. Okay, yes, it's a joint, yes, as I wrote in the abstract, it's joint with Roman Bezrukavnikov. In some sense, it's rather old work, which I put on a hive quite recently. And it's part of the joint project with David Kashdan, whose goal is to actually do it in a more general setting. So at least as in the first step, he wanted to do it for the zero representation, and hopefully even in more general case, but in the more general case, we have not even started to look to think about it. Okay, first of all, I want to say, first of all, what is the goal? What I want to achieve? Let us introduce some notation. Yes, unfortunately, will be some notation in this talk somehow. So F is non-Archimedean local fields. Yes, what else I need? WF, which is a Weyl group. What else I need? IF inertia. Yes, L as usual. So we will do some geometry. So it will be prime, which is different from characteristic of F. Okay, maybe even better residue characteristic, but let me ignore it for a moment, because when it comes to geometry, it will be only positive characteristic, so it doesn't matter. G will be connective reductive group of F. And to this guy, we associate the Langlands dual group, which is the semi-direct product of the connected Langlands group with WF. And I want to say it is dual group. And I will consider it over Q bar. It doesn't matter. I can view it as a group over any algebraic closed field of characteristic zero. Okay, now let me recall what the local Langlands conjecture says. Local Langlands conjecture says the following, that for every Langlands parameter, maybe even two parts, I would say, for every Langlands parameter lambda, which I will say this to G to the Langlands dual group, and I will put it over Q bar, and this is over, sorry. What's happened? And you want it over WL, of course. So if you over WF, to every one want to associate certain finite subset P lambda, which is finite subset of irreducible representation of G of F, which is finite. which is called L package. This L package is supposed to satisfy many conjecture properties, but I will want to formulate one of it. One of it, there exists explicit linear combination I will write it stable, which is, it will be sum of the certain characters of pi d pi, where pi, right, of characters of all representation such that this guy is stable. And actually, of course, as it's written, it is not so. Maybe I want to say it's true at least in the temperate case. In the non-temperate case, instead of it also should be okay. But instead of irreducible representation, one should take standard models, and then it also is supposed to be true. But let me ignore this subtleties. And in particular, what says A plus B? So A plus B implies that for every lambda, that there exists a natural map from gamma morphism from lambda's parameter. Okay, in lambda's parameter modulo conjugacy to the stable distributions. Stable invariant distributions. Stable. Where lambda goes to this character. Okay. So now natural equation or equation or expectation that this correspondence come from geometry, or maybe come from whatever natural geometric construction, whatever it is. Okay, and so what is actually so our goal? And maybe what I want to say. Whether they want to do it, you know, maybe even I want to say it's more precisely. More precisely, I want to say, what does it mean it's coming from some construction? For every lambda, I want to say it's certain geometric object. I don't know how I denote it. It doesn't matter because it will not appear. Maybe F not, because F will appear. Something. Lambda, which is what? It will be certain. I will write down and then I will explain what is written here. So it is LG modulo add LG. Where of course, so where LG is what is called loop group of G. It is certain in the scheme. I will tell a little bit later about what it is, because but it's something very huge object. It's somehow, you know, it's int pro algebraic varieties. So it's very huge object. You take this huge object, it is group object, you divide it by something, another huge object, meaning the same one taken by conjugation, get some very huge stack. And you can see that this is, when I say this is whatever category of elliptic sheaves. Maybe I want to write it here. Okay. So in some sense, it takes some effort to explain that this category makes sense. So it is what? It is derived category of constructible sheaves on this huge object, such that Besides that, you want this element, this one, is obtained from this by what is called shift functions correspondence. Okay. So in other words, that is what I want, that somehow I want that some it's distributions. I want to say gamma equal to trace of Frobenius, Frobenius on, I will say, of fiber. For each gamma, for example, in G regular symmetry. So it's trace Frobenius on some geometric object. This is somehow what we expect. And our goal is to show this kind of, yes, we have this kind of equality. To show a version, yes, to show this in a particular case. Okay. So this is a general thing, namely for certain Langlands parameter, we want to show that, first of all, that the correspondent stable distribution in given trace Frobenius on sums. As a corollary, okay, so question so far. Because I don't see you, so I would be glad if people ask question even before the question time. Okay. Dima, is it okay? So far, it's okay?
Yakov, the stability would be part of the deal, or it's an extra condition?
Ah, okay, yes. No, okay. So, okay, the question is, I will show formula, and this formula, okay, where I say this equality, and this will imply stability. Namely, I will show a certain formula, then using some another geometric result, I will deduce stability. So this was your question in some sense?
Yes, so what, I mean, my question was whether it has to do with some special properties of the sheaf, or it's true for any sheaf?
Yes. It will be shift of a certain special form. It will be co-invariant with respect to affine vial group, and actually there is some certain property of this co-invariance that supplies stability. I'm not sure I will have time to explain it, but maximum I will explain either in question time or privately after that. Yes, the answer is yes. It's somehow the stability is yes, and of course maybe I won't want to say as ask somehow you can ask there are some other linear combination which are endoscopic, and of course it's also expected that they also obtained by similar procedure, but I will not say anything about it. Yes, of course it's a special property of the sheaf which implies that it's stable. Of course. This is, so in some sense, this is why we are interested in, because it is expected that stability coming from geometry, in particular, if we have a geometric interpretation of characters, we expect that some kind of stability would follow from it. But so far, we have only one particular case in which we know how to show stability even without a geometry.
But can you even, sorry, probably I'm sidetracking you, but can you even make sense of the space of stable distributions in a geometric way? I mean, defined indirectly,
partly,
density.
Partly meaning on a regular semi-simple locus, yes. In general, I don't know. And it is unfortunate in some sense. Okay. On regular semi-simple, the answer is yes. But on not regular semi-simple, I don't know. I have some, whatever. I have some partial answer. I'm not sure this is correct. Okay, good. Let us start. Second, I want to formulate our main result. So our main result, I want to say what kind of lambdas I consider, what kind of lambdas parameter I consider, and what kind of shift we take, okay? And then somehow, okay, for simplicity, let F be, suppose we are in the mix, in the equal characteristic. Everything should be true in the mixed as well, but I have not checked. And let us assume that G splits over maximum unramified extension, which is, of course, in this case, this is just extended scalars, something like this. And yes, and we assume this, and we assume that somehow what we want to assume about lambda, we assume lambda three conditions. Lambda is tamely ramified. This is the first one. This first condition. Secondly, is lambda factor through image of lambda lies in the dual group of T for some elliptic, maximal elliptic unramified torus. So we have some torus T and G. It gives you the corresponding dual one. For example, it's important it's elliptic. Even if you take a G split, I want this guy is elliptic. And the second one, it is lambda is in general position, what is called. Yes, in general position. That is, it is a formal meaning that somehow if you take the centralizer of the image of the inertia, while the inertia is trivial, so you want to take image of inertia, and this is equal to T, meaning the connected component of T, right? Okay. Of course, inertia it's somehow because it's tamely ramified, then the image of inertia is just generated by one element, and you assume that this one element is regularly missing. Okay, so this is a condition. Okay, so why I consider this case? Because first of all, in this case, the pi lambda was constructed earlier. So in my work with Kasdan and debugger reader did it parallel. And also it was shown that the correspondence table, the distribution, which is just in this case, it is just sum of the characters. Is stable. Okay, maybe I want some digression. So it's all what I say, it's almost correct because formally speaking, both papers, our paper and the Barker reader paper, is written only in characteristic zero case, but nevertheless, our approach, because our approach, somehow P doesn't bias, it's true if P is good or very good, I don't know. What to say? I guess good is enough. Good meaning at least 7 or something like this. For other groups, even less. Okay, and so because it is P is good, that somehow that the assertion for the Yes, and by the way, when I say stable, is also there is a small cheating. What is actually written, proven, sorry, that they stable on the regular semi-simple locus, which of course in the characteristic zero it applies everything by theorem of Kalischandra, but in characteristic p it's not known that all the representation are locally L1. Therefore, I'm not sure that stability is shown on them. Okay. But let me ignore this. But yes. So our goal is so now. But as a result, we do have a distribution. We have a distribution. So now we have the only question whether you have this distribution, whether you have a geometric description of this distribution. Now, main result. Main result says the following. Okay, my results says the following. First of all, for every gamma regular semi-simple in F, we can state certain what I call flag gamma, which is affine Springer phi. This guy, it is a whatever scheme or locally affine type. So it's essentially an algebraic variety, except it might have infinitely many connected components, but there somehow there is some lattice acting and they interchange this component. For example, you can take something like this. So infinitely many P1s, but they are somehow, so it's variety something like this. So this is some guy.
It's and over a finite field?
Yeah. Again?
Is it over a finite field, everything now?
Ah, yes. Yes, this is over, thank you very much, over FQ, yes. Thanks. Yes, so I explained somehow in this equal characteristic case. So this is all finite field, thank you. Yes. Now, what I want to say is now by local Langlands correspondence for Torrey, lambda. Recall that lambda was the map from this to the dual of the torus. It corresponds. Yes, I will. So, okay, first of all, it corresponds to a certain character from T of F to QL bar. And this gives us, I will explain later, certain eliadic sheaf. Stable. This is certain eliadic sheaf. Actually, even not eliadic sheaf, even local system is called. Actually, maybe say rank W local system on. I will define it later when I formulate the results. There is some natural condition, and therefore, what we can associate, for every I, we can associate its homology group. F. And now what we know about this homology group, this homology group is equipped with an action with semi-direct product of the WG tilde, which is extended Weyl group and the Galois group of the finite field. This is somehow a general fact that somehow there is a classical fact for the usual Springer fiber. Usual Springer fiber are equipped with the action of the usual Weyl group, and the fine Springer fiber is equipped with the action of a fine Weyl group. And of course, everything is over finite field, so there is a Frobenius which acts compatibly on both ways. Okay, Now, in particular, yes, in particular, and now what is important that some, in particular, it is we can, for every J, we can consider the group cohomology. We can consider the group cohomology of the Weyl group on this cohomology, right? So on these X Galois groups, still X. And now our theorem says that lambda stable gamma equal to alternative sum of these guys. Of trace of Frobenius. Trace of Frobenius Q on these guys. You know, let us have for simplicity, let us, I will say this is HI. This is, I call HIJ. This is on HIJ. And by the way, of course, you might say, what does it mean? But you know, somehow, what is alternative sum? Somehow, you can say why it is somehow alternative sum of double things. But you know, somehow that all of the homologies can be taken. What is homology? There is a complex of vector spaces whose homologies are homologies. And now, what is this guy actually? Or actually, this one can be written actually better way. To write it lambda stable gamma, which is trace Frobenius of I would say, you know, okay, I will take the following. I will take this H, curl H of full G gamma. This is element in the drive category. So this is in the drive category. And we take, it happens. Okay, and I will say WG derived covariance. If you say somehow what is derived covariance is precisely the usual covariance is precisely the zeros homology. Derived covariance is taking all of them together. But there is one small issue that somehow, if you want to define this derived covariance, one has to go to the realm of infinity categories, because I will not explain why. Because if you want to define a covariance of something which is not a finite group, finite group is a covariant is exact functor. In particular, it's somehow the derived covariant is easy functor. The derived is anyway. So what I want to say is that somehow this alternative double sum can be actually written much more compactly in a sense that namely we consider a certain complex or element in the derived category on its X affine Weyl group and you take a derived covariance, whatever it means, and I take trace of cohomology on this. Yes, and of course, somehow remark. Yes, I told you. Okay, maybe I will not try right. It's a remark. Yeah. Okay, you know what? I will not try to write the remark. But somehow using this you could write down this geometric object on this loop space. But I don't want to talk about this. I know. Question so far. So, but anyway, but this alternative sum, it's something very, very explicit. It's a very explicit variety on its action on the its action on the of the affine Weyl group and I take its co-invariance. And also somehow using this form, you can explain why you actually have stability, for example. And the corollary of this formula might be a good form. Theorem 2 says that actually this is stable. That is, for every stably conjugate, gamma 1, gamma 2 in G regular semisimple F. Stably conjugate means the conjugate over the algebraic closure. We have equality. We have equality. Gamma 2. Okay. Yes, and this is, by the way, maybe I will later explain. If I have time, I will say a couple of words about the pool. The how is theorem 2 follows from theorem 1, but it's but what's important is because of this co-invariance. Okay, now okay.
Jakob, maybe I have another stupid and annoying question. Sorry. If I remember correctly, maybe I'm saying nonsense. I mean, but the group homology or cohomology, I don't know what you take here, it doesn't have to be finite.
Yes. You're asking a good question. What is true, somehow you have to, this HI, yes. As I told you, this is not finite. This is. A fine Springer fiber is not a finite type. In particular, this homology is infinite dimensional. But what is true that this homology is finitely generated W tilde model. If it is finitely generated W tilde model from this is follows from the fact that the W tilde is essentially a lattice, right? It's essentially lattice, so therefore it's finite cohomological dimension, then its group cohomology is finite dimensional.
So
because
the I
is,
right. The I and J is a finite.
Yes. Thank you very much. I forgot to mention that HIs are finitely generated W tilde models, and from this follows that HIJ are finite dimensional. Thanks. Otherwise, of course, the trace doesn't make sense. And of course, there are only finitely many I's and J's for each is the non-zero.
Yeah, that was my question. Okay.
So this is my question because W tilde has a it's what? It's semi-direct product over lattice, right? Over lattice with a finite group, because in EVM characteristic zero, therefore cohomology of finite so. Co-invariance with respect to finite group is exact functor. In particular, we are just interested in the cohomology with respect to z to the power n, and this has cohomological dimension.
So
it's fine. Yes. You're right. There are two issues. One issue that has to be finite dimensional, which is follows from results which one has to prove. They're not obvious facts. And another one is this finitely many. It's relatively easy. Good. Yes. And HI, the number of non-zero number I's for which HI is non-zero is finite because, as I say, a fine Springer fiber is finite dimension. It's also not completely obvious, but this is due to Kazan-Lustig. Okay, good. Now I want to explain a little bit more detailed construction. So I want to construct P lambda and so I want to actually remind you or formulate how the L packet looks like. Because, you know, suppose there is a quotient, there is a green, it's a quotient of two sides. I almost explained it to you the right hand side, except I did not tell you anything about how to get the shift. But I will tell you in a moment. But now I want to say something about left hand side. What is the distribution you're talking about? It's equality of something. Okay, and the answer is as follows. Okay, first of all, as I told you, lambda WF. It's lambda corresponds by local Langlands correspondence for toroid, which is due to Langlands, which is essentially classical theory plus some group cohomology. Okay, and now you want which is tamely ramified. So I say this is tamely ramified. It corresponds to this is also tamely ramified. Tamely ramified in this setting means that it's trivial on the first congruent sum. And in particular, it induces a gamma morphism from the T bar over Q to Q in bar where T is T mod whatever, maximal ideal. What was T, whatever. Okay. Because T was an unramified torus. In particular, every unramified torus, we can talk, it has a canonical or structure. In particular, we can associate the corresponding torus of the finite field. Okay, good. Now what we do is the following construction. So now remember T was in G was maximal torus, maximal elliptic torus. And now let alpha one, alpha n, which is embedding of T of G, which are so representatives of conjugacy classes, which of embeddings, which are stably conjugate to inclusion. We have fixed inclusion. And we consider this. You can actually do it slightly more canonical without choosing the inclusion, but let me ignore this issue. Okay. Now remember that somehow that you know that T was elliptic from this follows from every alpha there exists unique parachoric subgroup. I will say G alpha I in G such that alpha I of T of O lies in this G alpha because it's elliptic torus and somehow it's there is a unique point on the broadest building it stabilizes and somehow there is a unique parachoric which goes in this. Now if you have a parachoric, so every parachoric gives rise to a certain reductive group of a finite field, namely the Levy. Somehow this G alpha gives you certain M alpha I, which is reductive group over FQ, such that the set of FQ points, it is G alpha I modulo the G alpha I this pro-unipotent radical. So this is certain Levy. And now alpha, we say alpha into whatever, T of O goes to G alpha I, gives you alpha I bar embedding from T into M. And this is embedding as a maximal elliptic torus. Now what we have? We have embedding of the maximal elliptic torus. And also we have, before we had a character. Okay. And then what I claim is somehow to this guy we can associate the linguistic. Constructing certain representation, which is, I will say something, doesn't matter, alpha I theta, which is whatever, the linguistic corresponding to theta and whatever, alpha I of t, which will be representation of m of fq, m alpha I fq. Yes, actually, maybe I want to say that somehow it will be plus minus of this representation. Namely, what I'm using here, I'm using here that the T elliptic. And theta is in general position. From this follows the linguistic of whatever, the linguistic of this. Is plus minus irreducible Kaspar representation. Up to a sign, which actually I can tell you what is the sign. Sign is actually rank of the group. Yes, you know what? Let me write it. Yes, the linguistic of T and theta, it's actually minus one to rank of the group. Of irreducible Kaspar representation. This is just one of the results. And now what we do, so what we have a certain irreducible Kaspar representation of the M of lambda I, and then we define P lambda I theta by the following procedure. It will be induction to G of F, inflation from whatever, M alpha I FQ to G alpha I of this guy. So we take a representation of this Levy, M of lambda I FQ, it's finite group. We view it as a representation. Remember that somehow using this M lambda I is the quotient of the parabolic. In particular, we can view it as a representation of G of lambda I, which is trivial on the pronipotent radical, and then you induce. And now there is an easy fact. At least standard fact, I don't know, easy, it might be not the correct word, but it's definitely a relatively easy fact. Probably it's more prasad, maybe it was known before. Maybe some other people say that actually this guy is irreducible Kaspar representation. But pay attention that the construction is kind of involved, right? Because what we start? We start from the somehow certain data. We have certain maximum elliptic torus, take all conjugates, representatives of conjugacy classes of all embeddings. For each embeddings, we find parabolic. So there are different parabolic. For each parabolic, you produce this construction. So it is, yes. And now, And as before, we set lambda stable by the definition sum over all alpha i's of the characters of these guys. So at least I explained it to you the left hand side. So this is somewhat. Okay, so this is good. Now the last part I want to, maybe not last, I know, if I have time, I will explain the proof, of course. Now I want the geometric construction. Of character. Okay. So what I want to explain you, first of all, I have to explain you. So what we want to construct. Construct first, we want to construct the, I want to explain what is this affine Springer fiber. Secondly, I want to explain what is the sheaf. Which is a certain elliptic sheaf. And so I have to explain, but I will not explain how the affine Springer affine wire group acts on it. So in principle, I have to explain. After I explain it, then the result that I formulated makes sense. Then I take co-invariance and then the assertions are this. So I'm going to explain one and two. Okay, yes. So what about one? Yes, first of all, one. First of all, what is the flex? So let LG, which is called the loop group of G. Okay, so what it is? It is a functor. No, somewhat to say the geometric object, it is the same thing you want to say, which is such that I want to say what is its a point for each ring A. If I define it for each ring A, then I define it you a certain geometric object. Now, of course, after that, and then what you do, it is just G of A power series. So the means is very simple. It requires some time to some work to explain what it actually is. That is inductive limit. So in particular, it satisfies whatever we wanted. That the set of FQ points, it is of course G of F. Right. Good. So it is yes, there is a standard fact that it is whatever in scheme. Now let I LG be Ivachori subgroup scheme. So it's a certain subgroup scheme such that its FQ point is Ivachoric in the usual sense. Okay, I will not explain what it is. And now what is the flag variety? We said flag variety, it is just the quotient, LG mod I. It is analog, of course, of G mod B, which is usual for flag variety for the in the finite dimensional case. And actually a finite flag variety behaves as the usual G mod B flag variety, except it is infinite dimensional. So sometimes one has to take somehow to be more careful, but from many respects, it behaves as the usual G mod B flag variety. For example, for G is GLN, GL1, it is GL2, it is just P1, of course. Okay. Now, yes, now for every guy, yes. But now what's important that, of course, on this guy, there is a natural action on LG, right? LG acts by left multiplication. So LG acts on this. And now for every gamma in LG, we set what is the flag gamma is, what is LG, I will write down almost the same. This is the same as fixed points. So this is the definition. So GX, so you take gamma and you take its fixed points now explicitly. Explicitly, we can actually write that down the formula. The formula is the following. It's actually a very easy formula. It is the set of all element in G gamma in LG mod I, such that G minus one gamma G lies in I. Pay attention, it makes sense, right? G was defined after the multiplication by element in I, right multiplication, but of course, if you write down this formula, if you replace it by right multiplication, then you conjugate by some element in I, in particular, the condition that it belongs to I makes sense. Now, this is just easy exercise. And as I said, it is, this is a scheme locally of finite type over FK. Good. So this we did one. I explained to you what kind of object it is. Maybe yes. Now what about two? Two, I want to explain the shift. Just I want to. Okay. Now yes, as before. Lambda gives rise to theta bar, which is mapped from QL. And now there is a general fact. It's not T. I'm sorry. It's important. It's a character of the FQ points. Now there is a standard fact that every homomorphism from the torus gives you local system, local one system, rank one system, which is called theta on T. If you wish somehow, you can think topologically. Topologically mean what is local system? Local systems is a representation of the fundamental group. And now it's what is important, there is a Lyapunov isogeny. We have a map T to T, which is goes to T goes to whatever, T inverse Frobenius T. Something like this. And then what is kernel? Its kernel is precisely FQ point. So this is, this guy is Lang. Maybe it's the same L. It's not the same L. It is a Galois-Kakavarin. With Galois group T of FQ, right? Because Galois group is precisely the kernel. The kernel is clearly this. The fact that it is Galois covering is a snow, which is a standard fact in algebraic geometry in particular. But then if you have a certain Galois covering, then somehow by usual theory of coverings, at least in the topological case, it's give you certain local systems here. Now you want, so we have something on T, but now you want something on the flag variety. And there is some problem because there is no map. Problem, there is no map from the flag variety to T. But now it turns out that there is what is called abstract Cartan. Let TG be affine abstract Cartan. If you know what is Cartan in usual Cartan, that is TG is the I modulo I plus. So it is I modulo pro indigenous potent radical. It's just analog of the usual one where the usual epsilon Cartan is B modulo unipotent radical of BU. And now what's important, then there is a natural map which is, say, reduction gamma from the affine flag variety to the Cartan. Namely, remember what is this guy? If you have a map from G gamma, it goes to what? It goes to the, remember some, it's a set of OG such that this lies in I. So in particular, what we can take, we can take this element modulo I plus. It goes to G minus one gamma G modulo I plus. Okay. And now remember what we want. We want certain geometric object here and we need certain geometric object here. But the problem is, there is a small problem. There is an epsilon Cartan and there is a torus. And usually torus, of course, is isomorphic to epsilon Cartan, but it's not isomorphic canonical. But now what it is, there is a canonical. Yes, what I want, at least I want to say that there is a canonical double orbit of what I call admissible isomorphism. From T to epsilon Cartan, namely, if you wish somehow, if you have a fixed maximal split torus and you have arbitrary torus, and of course there is isomorphic by conjugation, but there is a choice. The choice is up to the W action. Okay. And now what we do is the following. Now for every phi, we can form the following guy, which is just phi of L theta. Remember here we have a canonical local systems here, and particularly you can push forward this to the epsilon Cartan. And now in what we said, L theta stable, it is just sum of the all phi L theta phi. And this is some completely canonical object in this it's local system. Maybe I want to say it is rank W local system on epsilon Cartan. And now after you do this, and finally, what I want to say is this phi theta stable, it's just, it's public. And this is the same it's local systems but on the affine flag variety. So if you wish, it is essentially you start from certain canonical rank one local systems on T, and then produce it's canonical rank W local systems on the fine flag variety, and this gives you whatever. Okay, and I guess essentially my time is over. And at least I formulate the results. Well, thank you, and any questions?
Let us thank the speaker, first of all. So questions, please.
Yakov, I don't know if it makes sense, but is there some baby finite field case, just like for the usual Berlin-Lustig that you can explain?
Yes, of course. This is of course you can ask the following thing. I have formulated you. Yes, I forgot to mention. Yes. I formulate this equality, and you can ask whether there is analogous result that we generalize. And the answer is, of course, yes. There is an important theorem of Lustig, which says that the characters of Dillon-Lustig varieties. You can write if you look at its character, it's given by trace of Frobenius on the corresponding Springer fiber. It's given by, if you wish, for example, it's given by character shifts, or in other words, character of the Dillon-Lustig variety is given by trace of Frobenius on a fine of usual Springer fiber. And of course, our goal, somehow, what we actually do, we use this variety to. We use this fact to show our results. Because remember that somehow our representations are induced from the Dillon-Lustig representation of the finite field. In particular, its character, of course, is obtained from this. Yes, thank you. Sorry, I should definitely mention it. Yes. So Lustig result, which is non, it's not obvious result at all. Which is a starting point of why it is so.
But do you use it as a black box, or you kind of have to open the box and?
No. We're using just in the black box. Okay, now in another project somehow with Dennis, etc. We have another more conceptual proof of Lustig theory, but it's another story. It might be more conceptual, but maybe it's longer because it's using this whatever. Infinity categorical machinery.
That was actually my second question. What comes into the proof? Do you need this stuff, or is it something that the caveman like me can understand?
No, essentially, okay. Maybe I want to, the following. First of all, what is the definition? The definition, remember, our definition was this guy. Right. So with the defined character is the sum of some character. In particular, if you want to give a geometric description of the sum, you have to give a geometric description of each individual term. But except the geometric description of each individual term is actually more complicated. It has more choices somehow. It's because, as you know, the stable distribution are better behaves. Yes, and now there are actually two cases, maybe not cases. There is a particular case and there is a general case. Particular case, if you take gamma geometrically elliptic. In this case, this affine Springer fiber are actually finite dimensional. And in particular, then we actually what we show is that actually that each individual term here, at least on the elliptic elements, elliptic meaning, sorry, on geometrically elliptic elements, on geometrically elliptic elements can be written as a trace of certain specific element which I don't want to define in the affine Weyl group, which depends, let's say, on some choices.
Geometrically elliptic, that's very rare, right? If I understand what geometrically elliptic
means. Yes. Geometrically
they don't exist for GLM.
But now you want to show it so that it makes sense. Okay, the form is the following. What we show, maybe I write, say something, what we show that actually is this, if you get a trace of P, whatever, alpha I theta gamma, it's the trace of the certain element, which whatever, alpha I theta, on the just cohomology. No, H star is alternative sum of the cohomology, meaning we don't take co-invariance, okay? Unfortunately, usually it does not make sense because usually it's finite dimension, it's infinite dimensional, but in particular, does it make sense? So what we do, we just introduce what we call generalized trace. By generalized trace, I mean the following somehow, because our representation might be what is the The correspondent result that you understand pretty well. How to understand what is the character of the induced representation? Character of induced representation, then you take the representation, the character of the representation you induce, and then take averaging. This averaging, of course, doesn't converge, but it is, doesn't converge absolutely, but it's converged conditionally. Namely, if you somehow, there is a way how to make it this. So what we formulate is the corresponding algebraic version. Namely, somehow this guy is equipped with the action. So on this guy, there is an action of a certain lattice. So we show that somehow if there is a guy with a lattice, then as somehow many people are connected to Bernstein in some way or other, then there is a notion of a good filtration. And then somehow we can show because of some specifics of the situation, and that not explicit, somehow there is an ellipticity assumption it's taken into the play. So this is somehow elliptic element. This is what is called elliptic. And then I claim if you take a good filtration and then for sufficiently large piece of the filtration, the trace stabilizes. So, and we call this, and also the resulting trace doesn't depend on the filtration, and we call it generalized trace. So in some sense, the difficult thing, but then you have to show for this, you have to show some finiteness properties of this cohomology with sort of complex support, which is not completely obvious. Let us say it took us another paper to write down for this technical difficulty. The idea is that somehow after you show a certain finiteness property of this guy, of the homology of fine Springer fiber, then essentially you just define the generalized trace, and then it's essentially the usual Lefschetz Grothendieck-Lefschetz trace form. So if you wish, it is Grothendieck-Lefschetz trace formula plus theorem of Lustig, which we use as a black box, plus some issue of what we do in the non-geometric elliptic case, which follows some of this, all this good filtration business, etc. So we have to develop certain machinery in order to make it sense. No, but it's rather elementary, yes, by the way. There is another approach using infinity categories, it's actually shorter, but in our preprint, we are not using this machinery of infinity categories. So it is just the usual graph categories.
Very nice, very nice. So maybe other people have more questions?
Could you please repeat the construction in number four?
Okay. You can ask what is the admissible isomorphism, right? Okay, I didn't define. There are two pieces. There are two steps. One it is there is something what is called admissible isomorphism. And another one, assuming that we know that there are admissible isomorphism, how we finish.
No, I mean the second one. What you did said it. I just didn't understand it at the speed.
Sorry. No. I didn't explain what is admissible isomorphism.
It's okay.
Now. Suppose you have a double orbit of an admissible isomorphism. Remember that somehow before I told you that starting from lambda, we produce certain local system on the T bar. Okay. Now suppose you have a isomorphism between T bar and the abstract Cartan. Then in particular, you can take this local system, rank one local system, and take it push forward. Mm-hmm. So we get certain rank one local system on. This assumption on the abstract Cartan. The only problem, it's not canonical. It depends on some choice. And what
so
you
what, we take what direct sum of all choices.
You take sum of the all choices, yes. And by the way, we need this also to, in order to get for various reasons. First of all, it's canonical. Secondly, because it's canonical, this is somehow, for example, each individual summa does not have a Frobenius structure. But the sum actually has a natural value structure because of canonicity. And also, and then after we have local systems on this abstract Cartan, then we take it pullback and get a local system on the affine Springer fiber.
And then you take some reduction.
No. I say there is this canonical map, as I told you.
So you take pullback under this canonical map.
Yes. No, by the way, what is this? Why this is a version, you know, there is a what is called usual in the usual setting, there is a G tilde. And there is a map from the G tilde. G tilde is the usual Grothendieck Springer resolution to the abstract Cartan. And what I wrote before, it is actually a fine version of this.
So I don't know this map. So the abstract Cartan, how is it constructed?
Okay. What is the G tilde? G tilde is for example is what is the element of G and B, Borel, for example,
yes.
Size G lies in Borel.
Yes.
And what you have this map? I don't know. Some letter phi is given. I don't know something phi of G B.
It's
just G modulo R U of B in B modulo R U of B, which is TG. Okay.
Yes.
And by the way, if you wish, let me explain in the finite dimensional case what is admissible isomorphism. In the finite, just the same. In the finite dimensional case, admissible isomorphism is the following. Suppose I have a T and G. What we do, we choose Borel, which contains T, and consider phi is the following. T goes to Borel, goes to B modulo R U of B, which is TG. So for every choice of Borel containing T, we have a canonical isomorphism between T and T of G, and you consider so it is admissible if there is a Borel solid obtained by this. And in the fine case, you just replace Borel by Iwahori, and everything looks.
Okay. Any further questions? Let's send the speaker again. So our next meeting is in 2 weeks, but in an earlier time. So 4 hours earlier, which is 1 p.m. Israeli time, because the speaker is from Japan. It's Shunsuke Yamana. And also I would like to say almost all lectures and maybe all lectures will be by Zoom. So I understood we caused some confusion for today. So even if the speaker is Israeli, it is at least by Zoom. There is some small chance that it will also be physical, but it's at least by Zoom. So everyone is welcome to always use the Zoom. And it's always the same link, even if you don't see it in the email. And you can see it on the seminar website. So see you in 2 weeks.
Bye.
And thank you again, Jakob, for the talk. I really enjoyed it.